Good morning, my dear students. In today's class, in the revision of the rotation mechanics, I have picked up some good numericals where most of the concepts will be covered in that one. We'll try to discuss as many as possible problems. So try to be till end of the class so that all the numericals, what all I'm brought it know, so you can think on them. And I'll give 2 minutes time for every numerical. Immediately the moment the question displayed, start reading it and start working it. Then I'll come into the picture. Okay, this is the read the question. So we have two this this B and A. There about point P is asking a point P and Q. There are 2 points are there. So this will be the point P. This will be the point P and this is a point Q. Angular momentum of ring one about point P. Angular momentum of ring one about point Q. Angular momentum of ring two about point Q. About point P, I'm asking about that ring one and also about the ring two. This is a very fundamental problem of just like conservation of angular momentum. Rather than fighting this, I think this is a very important thing. I just picked up so that a student must have a basic idea. So what is the, from where we will begin? So there's a formula. L bar is equal to I think this particular formula, if you can remember, RCM bar, RC bar, cross MVC bar plus IC into omega bar. Please do remember that I think that this is sufficient to work out most of the conservation of angular momentum problems or to find out the angular momentum. It is applicable for all. If only rigid body is having rotational motion, then this will be applicable. If only particle is moving that, or if a rigid body having both translatory as well as rotatory, I think this one formula is enough to find out the angular momentum of the rigid body, whether it's having only translative motion, only rotative motion, or both. This one. So let's go for LPZ. About axis passing through point P and perpendicular to its plane. So what will be the R bar? Here RC bar will become PA bar. Cross M. Velocity, that is VA bar. Put it here. Plus this one, moment of inertia will be IAZ into omega. What is the sense of omega? It was so minus K cap, you write it. Okay, let's the one PA bar, PA R bar cross P bar. It will be anti-clock plus K cap. This will become M. PA is equal to R, radius of that one. Both are having same radius. So this will become everything MVAR K cap IAZ. Rings are there, no? They are the rings MR square. And VA equal to R omega. So omega, I can write it as V by R minus K cap. Linear speed R omega. So this will be, I think, equal to zero. Okay, let me put it. This will become zero, no? This is of ring one. For ring one, it is. Ring one about P. Similarly, for the ring one, okay, for about P only we'll find out. For about point P, that of the ring two. So this will be LPZ. Okay, that's same equation, write it. No, what to do here? The perpendicular distance is what we will write it. The perpendicular distance is what we'll write it. So what is the perpendicular distance directly? If I go for it, this will become MVB. What is the perpendicular distance from A to A? This is R. Okay, this distance is how much? AB is equal to 6R is telling, 30 degrees. So we can get this distance. I'll extend this line. AB, I'll bring O. So what can be AO equal to? Sine 30 equal to AO by AB. AO should be equal to 3R. So LPZ is equal to, so PA plus AO it is. What about the sense? It will be into the plane minus K cap. What about the rotation? So this will become M omega square omega. This will be K cap. Okay, V equal to, this is, okay, let it be. Everything I should bring in terms of R omega, no? VA equal to R omega. I'm making changes, R omega. This let it be as it is omega. Anyway, it will be zero. This will be, the speed of the point B is 2R omega. PA plus PO. PA plus PO will be, AO is 3R and PA is R. So this will become 4R. Minus K cap, M omega square R plus K cap. 8, 8, 7, it will come. 7M omega square R minus K cap. The net of the ring, ring Q will say ring. Ring 2 I'll continue. Can you hear me? Shall I continue?
Yes, sir.
Ring 2 about point Q. I think this will be again the same formula. Straight away LQZ, you write it. I feel this is something very important. That this will be M R V B. So it should be K cap. This will be much easier. K cap. And this will become M R square ring into this will be omega. This will be K cap. So V B equal to 2R. V B equal to omega R. So this will become M R 2 omega R K cap. 3m r square omega k cap. This is about ring 2 about Q. So similarly, ring 1 about Q we'll find out. So for first it will be LQZ. Okay, same symbol. This will be, look at this one, M. What is the distance again? The distance will become 4R. I'll directly write it. 4R VA minus K cap plus. This will be M R square omega minus K cap. VA equal to R omega. So this will become 4M omega square R minus K cap. Of ring one about point P, which all options we can pick up? ring angle momentum of ring to about point P. 5m omega square we are getting, no? Only one option is matching. The two negative sign is only asked magnitude. Please do revise this. I feel very important. Conservation of angle. How to apply that equation is very important. I think I derived in class also, if you can recollect. Remember that formula. Okay, let me scroll to next problem. I'll scroll down. Problem got over. We'll take the next question. Here. Okay, see this very, don't get scared. I'll increase that angle is 30 degrees, this one. You can see things clearly. The angle made by the rod BC with horizontal is 30 degrees. That with the angle made by the rod AB with horizontal is 60 degrees. Well, I'll only magnify this. It will be able to see this 30 degrees. This 30 degrees is what given. We'll have this. Look at the right part. Okay, now looking at this diagram, we'll try to solve. Angular speed of the disk A, the total kinetic energy of system. We know only the angular speed of only the disk C. And it's telling they're rolling. The whole problem just revolves around that rods, looking at that rods. Rather than something going for the diagram, I will take help of. I think that this is enough. A student can, if he thinks this much of diagram, this will be enough. There's a point A, there's a point B, there's a point C. Now you analyze it. You know constant equation. Can you find out the speed of the point C and AB? Yes, but we don't know the linear speed is not given. One more condition, there's no slipping between each disk and the surface. I think this is enough, no? So what is the angular velocity of the disk C? Omega naught. So what is the linear speed of that? Should be VC. And how it should be horizontal. I think this is the very fundamental thing. From here is what your problem become. What is VC should be equal to? Mass M and radius 4R. What is the radius of this is 4R is telling. So therefore, what should be the VC? VC should be equal to 4R omega. Horizontal, don't put along the rod. Now you get into this one. So we know velocity of this. So this will make an angle how much? 30 degrees. And I'll slightly pull this. So this angle is 30 degrees. This angle is 30 degrees. How the speed of the disk B should be horizontal, no? It will also roll. So the velocity of the disk B will indicate how the velocity of the disk A. I think it's very simple problem now. So do we know VC? I know 4R omega. Then can we get VB equating the forces? So I think VB should be equal to VC, VB cos 30 for rod. You will write it here for rod BC. VB cos 30 should be equal to VC cos 30 degrees. VB, VC equal to 4 R omega. Then how to get VA and VB? That also, you know, the air also constant equation. This angle is 60 degrees. Then this angle should be 60 degrees. So this angle should be 30 degrees. Then constant equation for rod. AB it is equal to VA cos 30 degrees equal to VB cos 60 degrees or sine 30, any either one. So VA root 3 by 2. VB is what? 4 R omega cos 60 1 by 2. So VA is equal to 4 R omega by root 3. Can we get angular speed of, because it's a pure rolling? No, no. VB should be equal to, this is omega naught everywhere. Symbol, let it be. No, for pure rolling, VB should be equal to R omega B. This angular speed of the disk B. Similarly, angular speed of the disk A. VA should be equal to R omega A. What is VA? 4 R omega naught by root 3. Omega equal to 4 omega naught by root 3. Okay, these are all answers. After this, angular speed of disk, the total kinetic energy of system is asking. What do you mean by that? We'll just keep on add everything. The disk A is having mass M and radius R. M, it will have translative motion and also rotative motion. Rotative motion, due to rotative motion, it will be half M R square by 2 omega A square. I think omega A and omega B are different. Then M VB square plus half M R square by 2 omega B square. Then the kinetic energy of the disk will be, mass of the disk is M. M VC square by 2 of MR square by 2 omega naught whole square. Substitute all this, we'll get the required answer. So this is like a motion of connecting bodies. Okay, make observation. I'll slide down. The value of normal contact between the wedge and the sphere, the value of friction force between the wedge and the sphere. Wedge means here A. I think the yellow color wedge is fixed here. The wedge A and B will be in motion. I think if you can go back to the laws of motion, you do have numerical of this particular kind. Straight away, let me take this diagram. In this diagram, I'll show all the, okay, there's a fixed one. There's no problem with the yellow color one. Just highlight it. Okay, A and B is what you try to think. So what are the various forces that are acting? First, get with the weight of the triangular wedge of mass M is placed on a fixed uniform solid sphere of mass M. So both are having mass M. So what are the first forces will be? Mg sine theta, normal contact, Mg cos theta. Then there'll be normal contact by this also. if you resolve that, a component of that will be into sine theta, and this will be into cos theta. Then similarly, normal contact by the wedge on the sphere, it should be in this direction. Now, the what is the acceleration of, in what direction it will move? It will be in this direction. Acceleration of the wedge A should be down the incline. Take like this. I think this will be much easier now. Now, how to decide the direction of friction? So let's describe the motion of the sphere with respect to the wedge A. So then the pseudo force is what I'm going to take it. Component of pseudo force will act towards left. And it has to roll. There's no slipping, is telling enough to prevent slipping. So therefore, the friction must act here in this direction. Then on the wedge, the friction has to act here. The weight mg. Okay, let's write all the possible equations. So for the wedge A, see, all this based on the free body diagram. Once you should have a clarity of free body, rest all we'll see. First we'll write the equation, what are the unknown things to minimize, to overcome that unknowns, what further equations I can solve. So rather than fighting with the concept here, a student has to really put effort of free body diagram. So here the forces will be along the incline, MA, acceleration, this should be equal to MG sine theta plus N2 sine theta. Keep it here. N2A, so many unknowns are there. So then here N1 minus MG cos theta minus N2 cos theta equal to zero. This is equation one, equation two. Then on the cylinder, on the uniform solid sphere, on the solid sphere, what are the equations we can write it here? So the equations what we can write here is like the F plus, so here this one, MA cos 30. I think this should be the theta. MA cos theta minus F equal to M. AX, I'll write it, or AR, I'll write it. AR is the acceleration of the cylinder in this direction. Let this be alpha. Alpha or AR. That, how to get direction of friction? See, the direction of friction is, so now this will accelerate down, the wedge will accelerate down. Then this particular, you are going to stand on the wedge. Then you are going to put pseudo force, MA. Component of this pseudo force will drag this sphere towards left, because this force will pass through center of mass. If a force acts on a rigid body at center of mass, the friction should be backward. I think for a solid sphere, where the threshold point will come, at 2R by 5 above the center of the solid sphere. Above that, the friction will act forward. From threshold point to the lowest point, the friction will be backward. So therefore, friction will be backward. This component of pseudo force will try to move it, will try to produce translative motion. So point of contact will slip. So friction will be here. Then on the wedge, it should be towards left. Now condition for no slipping occurs, sir. Can't we think like this here? Because this pseudo force which is acting here will try to drag with respect to wedge, no? So therefore, there's the best way of doing problem. Try to do in ground frame, very difficult to analyze the friction. That's why I took the wedge frame. So MA cos theta, this one, MA cos theta minus F equal to MAR. So then rolling motion. What is AR? Acceleration of the sphere with respect to wedge. That's why I wrote AR. Acceleration of let it be. So this will be F into R equal to 2 by 5 MR square into alpha R. I think we have plenty of unknowns what to do after this. We have one more normal contact. N2 also we can write it. So what is the expression for N2? MA2 sine theta plus N2 minus MG equal to 0. All these are related to the sphere. A condition for no slipping, what we can write. So here the acceleration ER minus R alpha R, that should be equal to minus of component of acceleration of the wedge along the direction, along horizontal. It will be A, and this will be very important. Please do look at. So from where you brought it. Okay, well, once again, let me take this wedge. Here I'm showing it separately. Only accelerations I'll show it. The acceleration of wedge is like this. No, you resolve this. How much you'll get? Acceleration AA. AA sine theta. Acceleration of the wedge along x-axis, because it is sliding down along the incline. Let me adjust the position of this. Come for this one. Oh, we have so much of space. No, acceleration of the wedge along A will be, because this angle is 30, so this will be 30 degrees. I'll write it a little bit big. Cos 30 will come. Cos 30. I'll make changes here. This will become AA cos 30, no? And acceleration of center of mass of the sphere is this one, and it's having alpha R. So it will be AR, this will be R alpha. R alpha R. Acceleration of these two points should be equal, no? For no slipping. So therefore, minus is what you have to bring. Component of friction, I didn't write. My equation one, component of friction, I should write it, no? Okay, yeah, thank you. This will be minus F cos theta. Theta, I'll write 30 degrees. That will be better, no? Yeah, made changes. So what we have to do is like, just bring all expression for alpha R, R alpha R, substitute here. Expression for AR, substitute here. Expression for this acceleration, substitute here. Then what to do with N2? Again, this N2 you have to substitute here. This equation is a very fundamental. You have to dump everything in this equation. Then solve for friction. Once you get friction, then all other things we can find out. One, two, three. I have a lot of space. I'll do one thing. I'll push all these things. Yeah.
The second equation, we have to take a component of friction perpendicular also, no, sir. On the wedge A.
On the wedge A, yeah. Okay, this is the wedge. Anyway, that is. This we are very badly missing this one. Okay, now substitute 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in equation 6. Then you have to solve. can be asked. I think it's not that difficult. Can be attempted. Somehow what happened, the diagram, the free body diagram, but you try to do this problem with respect to ground frame. The biggest headache is in getting the direction of friction. Getting the direction. So in the wedge frame only, the problem will become very simple. Value of normal contact force between the wedge and spear. I think he's asking to get the N2. N1 is not needed. He's asking, anyway, this equation 2 is of no use. Substitute 1, 3, 4, 5 here. You have to work out. I'll slide on. I'll take the next question. Very, very simple. Moment of inertia of equilateral triangle plate of side length A about an axis passing through one of its vertices perpendicular to its plane is equal to I0. I think we should first get the basic idea what it is equal to. One of the vertices means and perpendicular to its plane. So where do that axis will come? Here it will be equilateral triangle. So it doesn't matter. So let me find out about this point. So this is the x-axis. This is y-axis. This is that point. And about z-axis is asking. So let me call that as A. Now this IAZ is what I0 given for us. This is the information. Hope I think this will be sufficient. Now he's asking what is the moment of inertia about axis OO dash. Will you go for finding out again the moment of inertia of this plate about A? No, it is given as I0. There's no necessity. No, again, don't go for any integration. If the four plates are there here, can we apply perpendicular axis theorem about X, about Y, about axis OO dash is asking. Do we know about axis O? Like a AZ, so this point, let me indicate this as A. In this given problem, we will indicate we'll take this as y-axis. This is x-axis. So now do we know IAZ? This is for one plate. No, total it should be 4 I0. Then I think symmetry is there. So therefore, IXA plus IYA should be equal to IAZ. And because of symmetry, IXA is equal to IYA. Four I naught. So IXA is equal to 2 I0.
Sir, is O dash along x-axis or z-axis, sir?
X-axis, no, we are assuming it. No, that's what the I brought from the diagram, green color. So therefore, this is nothing but IXX dash is equal to IOO dash. Both are same. Two I naught should be there. So what actually happens is like we start thinking first, okay, I should find out. This is given I naught, problem solved. I think answer should be 2 I0. When will be possible dates of your exam? Means any idea? No, we are in month of May, no? June, July, maybe July it will come. Are board exams cancelled or it is postponed?
Just postponed. No clarification.
No clarification. CBSE. Anything about CBSE? They have postponed or we will be done on June 1st regarding CBSE and state board. Oh ho. Our board exam they'll cancel. It's a very pathetic situation. A read question. This is again the body which is going to roll is a massless. In that have fitted a frame. I think I'm sure that I didn't discuss such problem. That's why I picked up here. Let's start analyzing it. Okay, read question first. What can happen to the body here? If the minimum value of coefficient of satisfaction which will prevent slipping is k by 10, find the value of k. This that ring. In that, we have to bring a frame. Now, let's get into the discussion. Okay, this is the, we'll take a position where it will be parallel to incline. The position of this, we'll keep it in parallel to incline. It'll be easy for us to write equations. Let one of the edge be parallel to incline. I think the problem is very easier. Now you can manage very comfortably. So whether each side is having mass m, so that 4 mg should act. What all that 4 mg sine theta will act here. Then 4 mg cos theta. Friction should act up the incline, no doubt, because it has to roll. It has to roll. Then for no slipping, acceleration of center of mass, AC, and let this be alpha C. C is the center of mass of system. If you want to, you bring also the normal contact. Of course, may not be, it's needed here. First, we should calculate the moment of inertia of this one. What we know the radius. We have to get the distance. So if you go back to again, we will. K equal to 4. Okay, yeah, fine. Yeah. K equal to 4 by, yeah, fine. Okay, right. Yeah. First, we'll get the moment of inertia. I think that's the only difficult thing. Rest all everything you can manage in the problem. Only the getting moment of inertia. So let this be the, what is the radius? Radius is R. If this is R, this is R. So what is the side length? Side length, let it be L. So this will become 4R, 2R, whole square equal to L square plus L square. Or this will become 4R equal to 2L square. So therefore, L is equal to R by root 2R. This will be the side length. Okay, if you know that, then we can get this distance, because this is what needed, no, for us to get the moment of inertia calculation. We needed this distance. Call this is y. So in the triangle L by 2y, and this is r. So r square is equal to L square by 4 plus y square. R square, L is root 2 r whole square by 4 y square. R square, this will be 2 is equal to r square by 2 plus y square. So y is equal to r by root 2. Now you get the moment of inertia. So how to get the moment of inertia? Find out for any one rod. The net moment of inertia of the system will be applying Parallaxis theorem. ML square by 2L plus MY square. Multiply this with 4 times. It'll be same, no? I see this will be. So 4M by 2L. L is root 2 R whole square. M is, I think this problem is all about only calculation of moment of inertia. Rest all you can manage. 2 will come outside. So MR square by 6. MR square by 2. The net moment of inertia of the system will be
8 ML square by 3.
8 MR square by 3. Okay, let's all, we'll write as usual, the typical rotation mechanics for problem. 4mg, you should not forget. Their mg sin theta, if you write it, gone. 4mac, then f into r is equal to ic into alpha c. For condition for PO rolling, ac equal to r alpha c. So what we have to get the mu, minimum quotient or minimum value of quotient of friction to get the front. First, we'll get expression for f here. So for that, I think we should admit AC. So this equation, substituting this will be, I'll carry on here. So this will become F into R, moment of inertia, what we got it, 8 MR square by 3. After getting this alpha C, I'll write it as AC by R. So F is equal to 8 MAC by 3. AC value I'll substitute in this equation. So 4mg sine theta minus f is equal to 4. MAC will be 3f by 8. 4mg sine theta. This will be 3f by 2. F plus 3f by 2. So f is equal to 8 mg sine theta by 5. No, after this, what to do? What is the maximum permitted friction here? Should be equal to mu s n, and that is equal to 4 mg cos theta. And we know theta is given 45. Now this friction for pure rolling, what is the requirement for pure rolling? This friction should be less than limiting friction for pure rolling, for no slipping. I'm just wanting to revise that idea. That's why I pick up for no slipping. F should be less than or equal to the limiting friction or maximum static friction. So this will be 8 mg sine theta by 5 should be less than equal to mu s n. What is n? N should be equal to 4 mg cos theta. I think now almost we are at the end. So theta is 45 degrees. So this 8 by 5. 4 mg, I think, okay, this is, I'm missing. So this will become 2 by 5. So what is value of mu s? mu s should be less than or equal to, no? So mu s is what? 2 by 5 or 0.4.
Sir,
okay, yeah.
We can use mu minimum equal to tan theta by 1 plus mr square by h now, sir.
Directly you can go for it. Just I wanted to make you everyone to revise once again the basic idea from where that condition formula has come. The numerical is all about, there's a very best problem I feel like. Okay, you brought it. Now what will happen? I'll apply a force. You start analyzing. So like this, like in a massless ring, a frame will be put, or I'll bring a cone, whatever that one, no? The different objects I can bring. I can inscribe if there's a thing. I can even put a cone, no, or a triangular plate. This will have a mass in. This is massless ring, light ring. This small idea is enough. Then I will project with a velocity V naught. After what time it will attain pure rolling. So this will be more troublesome. That's why what you learned, no, this is what you should able to multiply it. Got the idea, no? So we need not to bother. Only thing, getting the moment of inertia of the object which is there inside that ring is very important. That if you get it, again, we can continue the problem. Or I can apply force. Instead of giving velocity, I'll apply force. I'll apply force at IH point. So many ideas will start coming. Then where the friction will act towards right to towards left. What is the major problem? It is not a ring where it will become at IH point, friction will be forward. I think we have to be very careful here. So first, the moment of inertia of this plate has to be determined. You have to solve the problem. You assume the friction. If you get positive, okay, you assume in right direction. If you get negative, then you have to change the direction. So here I'll just assume it to be like this. Then I'll proceed into the problem. I'll solve it. If I get positive, what I assumed is right. Now we'll take the next one. I read the question. If a car is moving rightward with an acceleration A equal to, the rod maintains its orientation as shown. We have very few problems of like a pseudo force setting up a torque. Am I right? So pseudo force can set up a torque. It can set up a torque, no? When system is in equilibrium, there won't be any problem with that. We can apply. Like a pseudo force can set up a torque. Yes, it can set up a torque. So there's no need to bother. So what are the various forces that will be acting is the normal reaction, Na, here Nb, the weight of the rod, Mg, and pseudo force, Ma. I think now just only writing torque equation, sign solving. So now, as shown, neglect friction and roller, and the rollers are small and light. So what are the equations we can write here? Na minus M into A equal to zero. This is the one thing. Then Nb minus Mg equal to zero. Talk about which point we can define. Talk about any point P. Talk about point P will be Na L sine 30. That will be clockwise. Ma L by 2 sine 30 anti-clockwise. Mg into L by 2 cos 30 degrees anti-clockwise. All this should be equal to zero. I think his only thing is this may not be needed. This NA is what you're going to substitute MA. Then simplify, this should be equal to zero. We'll get an expression for acceleration. A pseudo force can set up a torque. I think somewhere in more than one option, they may trouble you. So there's one example is what I'm giving. There's no. In the ground frame, sir. In the ground frame, how the conditions will occur? Who is writing all these equations? Person in the trolley. Person on the ground, anything, how you'll write it. You'll just write this equation as this force will accelerate the center of mass. You write equal here. Then the weight mg is balanced by this one. Sir, what about this equation? How you write in ground frame? How to write this equation? About same point. Point B is now accelerating, no? Point B is accelerating. The point which you're putting, no, that acceleration. So that has to be taken here. A very simple idea. Nothing is there. Within by seeing only you can do this such numericals. I'll slide down. I'll scroll down. K equal to 1/3. Yeah, fine. Okay, thank you. This is some, everyone knows impulse on a rod, everything, but look at the options. Some very, very good conditions are being asked again. A rod AB of mass and length L lies on a smooth horizontal table. An impulse J is applied to NDA as shown in figure. Immediately after imparting the impulse, he's asking some queries there. Radius of curvature of trajectory of A as seen from the ground is. I think very peculiar, no? We never bothered about that one. So how the point on a rod, it will have both a translatory as well as rotatory motion. So definitely some sort of curved path will not be like a translatory motion. The points on a rod will not have only translatory motion. They'll be moving in some curved path. So when the curved path comes, definitely radius of curvature will come into picture. So shall we derive an expression for how the displacement of a point will vary in XY plane? I think we'll invite big trouble. So what is the alternative for this? We'll go back to circular motion. If a particle moves in a circular path, then what is the radius of curvature equal to? And centripetal acceleration should be equal to square of tangential speed by radius of curvature. I think there's a formula. What we know is we are going to apply it. Where this will become rho. I'll write it where rho is the radius of curvature. Anyway, here there's no radius is there. Let me keep it here. If the particle moves in circular path, that radius of curvature will become radius. If it moves in curved path, the distance from the point on a arc to a center of curvature will become radius of curvature. So we should get these things now. We should get this. We should get this one. From where this an will come. Okay, let's see what all we can do after impulse. I bet there's a good problem. A little bit we have to put effort. It's not that easy. We have to analyze things. Okay, the velocity of center of mass, we'll put C, velocity of center of mass. So what is the velocity? Or V naught, we'll write it. V naught equal to, what is that V naught? Earlier the rod was at rest. Just after impulse, it starts moving. So what is J equal to MV naught. Then there'll be an angular impulse is set of, no, J into L by 2. And about what point the rod will rotate? About center of mass. Because it's set free to rotate, it will rotate about its own center. So here we'll bring omega naught. So then the equation will be J into L by 2 ML square by 2L omega naught. Substitute J here, MV naught L by 2 ML square by 2L omega naught. So V naught is equal to L omega naught by 6. The relation between V naught and omega naught. Till here, no problem. The midpoint of the rod will move along a straight line. The incident axis of this distance of L by 6 from the midpoint. I think first option C and D will manage. The different points will have different velocity. So there's some point P, I'll put it. I'm trying to search instantaneous center, which is at a distance, say like a X. So what is the velocity of that point? The velocity of that point should be zero. So how velocity of that point will be zero? Vp should be equal to V naught minus X omega naught. So V naught is there. Omega naught will be V naught, 6 V naught by L. So therefore X is equal to L by 6. So there is a point on a rod where at that instant its velocity will be zero. So therefore point P is what? Instantaneous center. If you go for option A and B first, I think you'll invite big trouble. If you first do C and D, you'll be in better position. That's for the very intelligently the options are also placed. Instant center, at that instant center means for that position. Afterwards, the orientation of rod will change. Hope everyone is able to understand. Immediately, we are just doing at that instant. When the rod is what you're seeing in this position, then this point P is instant center. Okay, now. The radius of curvature of A as seen from the ground is 8.9 by L. Of point A. Okay, that is asking only point A. Here I'll myself for 1 or 2 minutes, I should permit the students to analyze. Okay, I'll just pause the recording. I know anybody got the idea what to do with. So now let's do one thing. Anybody wants to share your idea?
Sir, at point A, we'll write velocities.
Okay, what about acceleration?
Sir, acceleration is omega square r naught. Omega naught square r.
What is r?
Sir, r is L by 2.
That's what. See, it is rotating about center of mass. About center of mass, it will have only rotative motion. That one, it is rotating all the system. So from there, we'll get the centripetal acceleration. And we know tangential velocity, total velocity. Or shall I take only translational velocity or total velocity? There are one more issue. I should go the total velocity, velocity of point A. Then there'll be a centripetal acceleration. From that is what I should bring here. Or if you stand at point P, the whole all points on a rod will appear to rotate about point P, no? I think where you had a problem of this one, I think if you go for a rolling body, there we asked about when it's having a pure rolling, the radius of curvature of various points. Hope you remember some 3 problems we did. The same idea is what I'm bringing here now. About its center, we'll calculate the acceleration. So acceleration, first velocity of point A. Velocity of point A will calculate, then acceleration of point A. What is acceleration of point A? Should be equal to omega naught square into L by 2. Omega naught, I think we should bring in terms of everything. Omega naught is 6 V naught by L whole square. This is L by 2. Further V naught, what we can write? V naught, okay, let it be in terms of V naught only. This will 36. This will be 36 by 2, 18. 18 V naught square by L. This is the acceleration. Then what is the velocity of point P? Velocity of point P should be equal to V naught plus L by 2 omega naught. L omega naught will be 6 V naught. This will be 3 V naught. 4 V naught will come. So now I'll get into the radius of curvature. Acceleration of A, V A square by, let me write some rho. This will become 18 V naught square by L. 9 by 8, or sorry, 8 by 9. 8 L by 9. Please do remember, not only for rolling object, I can ask you for any other thing. So have a look at once. We'll go to the next question. I'm bringing some variable mass concept in this question. Rolling and variable mass concept. Now, for first, there's a collision between them. So what shall we do? We'll apply conservation of linear momentum. Applying conservation of linear momentum, mv naught should be equal to, mv naught should be equal to the m by 2 plus m by 2, no, into some v, we'll write it. That is the initial velocity v1. A bullet of mass m by 4. Later on, I'll substitute the value of that small m. Is m by 4, that one. So this is v1 equal to mv naught small m by capital M. This is m by 4. So substituting this, I think we'll get v naught by 5. I think option A, no problem. Very easy. Good question. Then afterwards, assume that amount of gas emitted during the collision can be neglected. The compressed gas emitted constant velocity V naught related to ball and at an even rate. Find the velocity of ball as a function. Assume that emission of gas charge. What is the final velocity of the ball? Shall we bring rolling here? See, the final exam. See, now you're discussing rotation mechanics. Okay, final exam. How do you get idea that is rolling is there or not? If he mentions that there's no slipping, the friction is sufficient for pure rolling, or the surface is rough, okay. Kept on a frictionless table, so no question of anything rolling here. Got the idea? There's no question of anything rolling here. Intentionally, I brought it. So more maximum students is kept on a frictionless table, they don't read. They start bringing rolling ideas or the thing, nothing to do that. So what is this problem? This is like a similar rocket proportionally with initial velocity there. So directly go back and substitute, you'll get the answer. No need to derive also. So what is the forces that are acting? I think, see, it's not only for anybody what will happen. This is what happens like when we go for the total syllabus, this is what happens. To make the decision of the question itself a big headache. Forget about solving. Once you get a clarity, then it'll be very easy to manage. So here it was imparted a velocity, how much? V1. Then inside, what is there? Mass m by 2 will not change, mass of the ball, and a gas will have m by 2, and the particle will get embedded. Let it be there inside small m. This is V1. Now that particular gas will be ejected relative to ball at an even rate. So how that gas is ejected relative to ball at an even rate? So will it be towards left or towards right? I think that is not mentioned. So let me assume towards left here. So here is a small hole is there. through that it will be ejected. So after some time, the velocity of this will be V, and air gases will be ejected. With a velocity Vr. Now, will there be any thrust force will act? Yes, there will be a thrust force. This thrust force will further make it to translate it. So it will start with a velocity, that's all here. So what is the basic formula now? The thrust force should be equal to Ma, total mass of system. Or M of T, I'll write it. And this will be a better equation. M of T, A, you write it. No. So what is the thrust force should be equal to? K V naught by 2. This thrust force here, the mass is decreasing, no? So therefore, I'll bring my negative sign. Then what is M of T? This will be small m plus m by 2 minus kT. Because the other the gas, what happened, its mass will be changing. This should be equal to dV by dt. Now you integrate and you'll get the required answer. In the limits, what you have to put at t equal to 0, it was having velocity v1.
Sir?
Yeah.
In the first equation, it should be only small m plus capital M by 2, no, sir?
No, total system. It cannot be like that. It will be total system. Very, very, very important that is. Gas mass also has to be considered.
Okay, sir.
I think we have to rearrange and we have to integrate. Initial velocity it will be, so I'll bring it dt k v naught dt small m by 2 kt equal to dv. This negative sign, okay, we'll keep it here. Then the limits will be at t equal to 0. This is what happened at t equal to 0. Collision happened. It was having velocity v1 at any instant of time, let vt be the velocity. Okay, no, I think it's a simple idea. This is fundamental. Usually, will it collide with only ball? No, even the mass of the gas, because the momentum, what it acquires will be, even the gas will also acquire that momentum, no? So therefore, it has to be taken, mass of the gas. I have this answer. V naught 1 by 5 plus log further I could, okay, we can simplify till here. Yeah, try it later on. It just only integration. Let me move to the next question. If so same thing. If it is a rough surface, is rough. Surface is rough, I think this point all the time the thrust force will not be in same direction, will be a very complicated one. Because surface is rough, the very moment it starts moving, so definitely the friction will come, then it starts rolling. Again, you see that the thrust force will continuously change its direction. Very difficult, the mathematics, what we know. Or at our level, I think not possible. And this again comes in the category of connecting bodies. We don't have any numerical till date on the rolling of connected bodies. Please do verify such small things. No, will help you a lot. There's a ring and disc are there. Read question. I'll set the diagrams. There are particular, then I'll pull this one. It's a rough, the surface is rough. What conditions will arise here? The frictional force acting on the ring is asking, shall we solve this or shall we directly say that it is having some value? I am asking, since you know so many things, will you go for really solving, or you have some information, better to use that information? But the moment I apply force, no doubt. So what about here, friction at the disc, in what direction it will act? I think these are primary questions we'll ask ourselves. In what, sir, how to decide the friction at this point? Towards right or towards left? No rolling, so rolling will take place. The frictional force acting on the ring, this one. So definitely the friction is sufficient for pure rolling, we'll put it. And that's basic idea. So friction should be forward or backward? It should be backward. If you put forward, what problem will arise, we'll see. If you put forward, then how the alpha angular acceleration will be counterclockwise, then slipping will occur here. Friction sufficient for pure rolling. I'll add that comment. Friction sufficient for pure rolling. Okay, now I think this will be not possible. The friction should be, yeah, let me call F1. The tension, the string, let it be T. Then you go for the ring. If a force acts at highest point, what will be the tension or any external force? The friction acting at the surface will be zero, because the threshold point for the ring will be at highest point. For the disc will be at R/2. Here, sir, I don't know all that. It's a memory based. Okay, you assume friction, solve the problem, then apply all the things. So let acceleration of this be A1, angular acceleration of this be alpha 1, acceleration of this be A2, angular acceleration of this be alpha 2, solve it, you'll get F2 0. Or else, in a very simplified way, what is that? If you apply force for the ring at highest point, because for the ring, the threshold point will be highest point. When you apply force at the threshold point, the friction should be, rolling friction should be zero. Or how to solve this? The equations will be of this kind. F minus T minus F1 equal to ME. Then. F1 R minus TR equal to, this will be MR square by 2 alpha 1. A1 equal to R alpha 1. Then condition for no slipping, A1 equal to R alpha 1. I'm bothered about these points. The string should be taut. So during motion, what is the condition? They should be taut and inextensible. So therefore, primarily what I should write, acceleration of point P1 along x-axis must be zero, acceleration of point P along x-axis. The direction of friction, it should not be forward. If it is forward, alpha will come like this, then slipping occurs here. So the friction on this disc should be backward. On the ring, if you apply force at threshold point, the friction acting will be zero. On any rigid body, if you apply force at threshold point, the threshold point for the ring will be at highest point. For the disc will be R/2. Hope if you can remember, if all of you can remember that one. So I'm very sure that answer F2 will be zero. That I'll show it mathematically here. So AP1X should be equal to A1 plus R alpha. AP2X should be equal to A2 plus R alpha 2. I think this is a primary equation. For the ring, we'll write the equation T plus F2 equal to MA2. Then T into R, F2 into R equal to MR square alpha 2. Then A2 should be equal to R alpha 2. Solving all this, you'll end up sure, for sure, F2 should be zero. What you should do here is like A1, substitute here. R alpha 1, substitute here. A2 substitute here. Or A2 equal to R alpha 2. That you can write it 2A1 equal to or A1 equal to A2. Solving this, we'll get expression for tension and friction. But sir, like look at the unknowns. F1, F2. So many unknowns are there. Can we really manage this? So this T gets eliminated. Huh? It's very simple. A1 equal to A2. Add up these two. F1 and F2 will come into picture. That then here also you have here, no? So actually this T will get eliminated. F1, F2 is things where you'll get that one. F1 will be non-zero, F2 should be zero. So rather than this, I suggest you must take help of what, like, if you apply force at threshold point for a rigid body, the rolling friction will be zero. Directly you can write F2 zero. I think the intention of the question was to answer directly rather than solving in this way. I'll scroll down. This will be, I think, have a time. Let me check it. Okay, 1 o'clock, I have a class. These two you can manage. Yeah, so we'll do one thing. At least we'll finish off this one. Only another 10 minute time is there. Simple, I think, rotational equilibrium, nothing big. There's a pivot. The board pivots only at the pivot, the board pivots only at the pivot point A, sits exactly at the middle of the board. The force necessary to hold it. So on the board, what are the forces? We'll put it after this. So first, what is the force? Shall we put here F or F cos theta? Should be F only. And this should be 2F. Or F sine theta, anything shall we bring? Because that force applied is making certain angle. I think with what force you pull the rope, that will be the tension at every point. No? So then this will be. The weight mg will act. And this is 2F. What to do with this theta? X equal to 5. 25 Newton you're getting. Okay, fine. I think this will be sufficient, no? Just apply torque about this point. Theta, if I make 30 degrees, 60 degrees, will it matters here? Nothing to do with that. No use of theta here. Unnecessary this one. So directly you can go for 2F, then apply torque 2F into L equal to mg into L by 2. One more there. We'll wind up this. A cylindrical pulley of mass M and radius R is connected to another cylindrical pulley of mass M by 2 and radius R to a massless string shown in figure. If sufficient string is wrapped over large pulley, the aggregation of mass M attached to smaller pulley. This is again, there is some small basic observation student usually do miss. There should be a rope from here, no? It is attached. I to explain the very neatly, so I'm taking the diagrams here. Then that string will be passed and will be, it should be very smaller. Okay, I think my diagram got over. So this will be owned on it, and we need not to bother. Why this one here? Let's get into this one. So what is it? This also having a mass, m by 2. And again, it's suspended by mass mg. So what are the forces? This will be mg, the weight mg will lie. Here tension T. What shall I take tension here? T by 2?
I think we'll land in very big trouble. So here you write T1. This is T2. This will set up a torque. This is having mg, so here torque it will be there. So this will start rotating. So let me write this alpha 2. Whatever this acceleration of this should be equal to acceleration of this point. And this will have rotation, say alpha 1. Now the constraint equations will come into picture. So this you write it p, this is q. Then acceleration of point P along y-axis should be zero. Why it should be zero? Because it is directly connected to this particular point of suspension. So here the constant equation will be A minus R alpha 1, 0. What about acceleration of point Q? Acceleration of point Q should be equal to tangential acceleration. Here. Q, I'll write it S better. Should be equal to AS. What is AS? AS should be equal to R alpha 2. What is AQ? AQ should be equal to the biggest problem, students, they'll put tension to be same. If tension is same, net torque is zero. How come it will have angular acceleration? So the tension must be different. I think some of you can reach here. Then the rest all you write all the equations. The torque 1, T2, about this point, so T2 into R should be equal to MR square by 2 into alpha 2. Then T1 into R, T2 into R should be equal to, again, cylindrical pulley it is, so mass is mass of the pulley, M by 2, radius is R by 2 whole square by 2 into alpha 1. Then it will also have translative motion, T plus mg by 2 minus T1 minus T2 equal to m by 2 A. Then mg minus T equal to ma. The problem may look little bit simple, but here is what maximum students will go wrong, especially in exam, current situation. It will not flash for you. So what is the basic thing is like when tension, here, what is the basic necessity? This is having a mass since it's having some rotation motion. So net torque should be zero. Therefore, the tension has to be different. If this is massless, then you take same tension. If this cylindrical pulley, small cylindrical pulley, if it is massless, then you have to put same tension. I think very, very dangerous things. Huh? You have to, whenever a pulley is having a mass, you have to be extra alert. Pulley massless, okay, you have got freedom. Tension T1, T2 equal to T1 equal to T2. I'll write that condition here. This is, we'll say, smaller pulley. a smaller pulley is massless, then P1 equal to P2. I think it just revolves around this idea. Nothing big is there. So you can expect questions in exam of this kind also. I feel there's all possibility of asking simple pulley constraints. I'll end up the meeting. So I have another class. Okay, thank you all of you. Notes, I'll update it. Some folder I'm using for other thing, like I'm unable to share that drive. I'm finding difficult that one. It is be used for HAP and other things. Just another 2-3 days, have patience. Everything will be there in front of you. Okay. Okay, bye, see you. Take care. Yeah.